So we've come today to document this historic building in Rochester from an auditory and acoustical perspective to begin documentation of what we call aural heritage, so the sound sensing characteristics for people of spaces, spaces of social and cultural historical importance, such as this building to Rochester.
So basically using this technology, we can change your room acoustics as if you are in Carnegie Hall, or as if you are in this Rochester Savings Bank, or in Bob Dylan's studio. In the living room, you can experience all different kinds of acoustics of the world.
To do that, we have a lot of loudspeakers set up and microphones set up, and we will capture the acoustic reflection coming from the walls and the building.
So we are basically sweeping tone from low frequency to high frequency, and then each frequency is activating the room behavior. And by recording that specific tone, we can actually capture the room behavior. We're trying to sample some spot which actually reveal the most characteristic acoustic behavior of this building. So we imagine that where would be the most kind of active thing would happen in this building 100 years ago. Because one position does not actually symbolize the entire complexity of this building's acoustics. So we're trying to capture as many as possible. So we want to preserve that acoustics in a digital form so that in future we can restore that acoustics in any event.
Acoustics is a big part of the life, big part of the human behavior, and that's why we want to measure this accurately. When you have a good acoustics, it enhances the quality of the performance. It also enhances the enjoyment of the playing.
And we're very interested in the end of all of this, in translating what we measure and record today to something that people can listen to and that can feel with sound, with their whole body.